a long time ago started with 1,000 flyers that I handed out in Chilliwack just at the parking lots and Superstore. I couldn't literally pass children and parents without handing them this form. So I've been on this journey, and when they said it was mandated, it wasn't, so I started handing out talking sheets about it's not mandated. And one of the things I handed out was, is that there's part of the School Act that relates to educational resources, which states, any concerns or challenges to the use of a learning resource should be dealt with at the district level. Boards, authorities should also develop policies and procedures to challenge the use of a learning resource. So I went to every Chilliwack meeting, school board meeting in the last, since Christmas. They know my face. And I found out you couldn't challenge a resource until they accepted it. So when all the trustees, well, not all the trustees, but enough accepted it, I said, okay, now I can challenge it. So I said, what do I need to do to challenge it? So they sent me the form, 606-1. So in your school districts, there's a form that you can ask for from your districts. That's a challenge form, and they will, it's different for different areas. Christian's was just a one question, a one question. Mine was like five questions. It's basically built for a resource like a book. So it starts out the name of the book, the author, whatever. I wasn't challenging a book. So my first challenge, I challenged them the inclusiveness of the 10 components, which are not inclusive. And I said, why they're not inclusive. So I challenged that. She came back, the superintendent came back and said, you can't challenge that because it's not a resource. So here I am standing in the school board meeting, and I'm standing waiting for the first question of the day when they finished their introduction by saying, we're not allowing any SOGI questions today. And so I shrug my shoulders, and they know what I'm there for, so I say, okay, but I'm here anyway. So I asked him, I said, okay, since you've now rejected my challenge because you said it wasn't a learning resource, you know, it wasn't the right part of SOGI 123, I said, my question is, what is the right learning resource part of SOGI 123? Well, the chairman and the superintendent looked at each other's, and they kind of shrugged and said, well, we're not the experts on SOGI 123. And I said, okay, you were expert enough to dismiss my challenge by saying it was the wrong part of SOGI 123, but you're not expert enough to tell me what part is the right part. So I said, okay. So I went to my purse and I picked out my second challenge that I made before I went there, and I handed it on camera to every trustee in the room. Okay, so
wow.
She didn't get back to me right away that she'd accepted it like she did the first time, so I thought, So I gave her a note and I said, okay, when can I have a response on this challenge? So she got back to me and said, May 11th. On May 10th or 9th, she got back to me and said that she'd like a public meeting. Well, you can call my challenge or any challenge, informal challenge, and they can talk to you and dismiss you. I thought that's what she was doing, so I said, no, I can't come. Till finally she emailed me her response, which I now have in writing, where she tried to dismiss the challenge again. So what I had challenged was the first line in the curriculum, which states from K to 12, and the words are, learning requires exploration of one's own identity. And this is from kindergarten. This is the whole thing.
Right.
If I can challenge this, it's done.
Right.
So I said, I am challenging this statement as the part of the learning resource of this statement. So that's, and I won't go into the five things that I challenged, but it was the mental health ones that Jen's talked about. It's about the, you know, they're exploring their identity and they're confusing them. And then, anyway, I can't remember the five. I've got them here. But the big thing is, so then she got back to me and she said, okay, she dismissed my challenge because the person I used that had damage, the anonymous mother that I quoted that took her two kids out of school, I didn't name her. Well, because she hadn't taken them out of school yet. And so I sent a statement and I said, and I actually went to the mother and I said, I think she's going to come back and say, you're anonymous. I can't speak for an anonymous mom. And I said, can you use her name? And she said, yes. So I had an immediate response when the superintendent then came back to me and said, you know, she's anonymous. I said, okay, she's not anymore. So I gave her name and her school, and this is what she came back with. While I cannot further discuss with you the details regarding decisions made by families, I can confirm that the information we have is that the family's decision you speak of, who has chosen to homeschool, has many other factors related to their decision other than choosing a Christian-based education. Then she says, I believe it would be incorrect to characterize their decision as supporting your statement of being vehemently opposed to SOGI 123, who remain silent because the school system has control of their children, and the only safe way to take a stand without having your children targeted is to remove them from the system. Our schools are, oh, I don't think I have the last line, but then she goes on to quote, our schools are safe and inclusive of everybody, et cetera, et cetera. So I thought, okay, now what do I do with this, right? She's tried to dismiss me again. But I wasn't sure what Victoria had actually told her, because I assumed that she had talked to her. So I talked to Victoria and I says, did you get a call from the superintendent? Because there was actually lots of reasons she was taking them out. They weren't learning anything. They were watching Disney movies all the time and all kinds of reasons. So I wasn't sure what she'd said. But she got back to me, she said, no, I did not talk to anybody, was I supposed to? And she hadn't talked to anybody. No one had had a discussion with her, even at the school, with her own teachers. When she asked her teacher what was going in her class, the teacher responded by pointing to the gender-neutral bathroom that was around the corner, letting them know very clearly what side she was on, and that she didn't have time to talk with her any further. So there was no discussion. She's had no conversation. So I thought, okay, well, there we go. So here was my response to her. I further addressed the challenge number two. Number one, you have not even spoken with Victoria, and you have neither the right nor the responsibility to determine someone else's motivation or the extent of the damage done to their children. Number two, you yourself called SOGI a learning resource in your email to me, and as such can be challenged. I have taken one aspect which helps facilitate discussion and evaluation. Number three, as a formal challenge, it is the responsibility of the board to proceed with the committee to determine the value or danger of this resource being taught to all students at any age, and address each of the concerns with solid proof from studies, etc., that validate the use of this resource. I await the forming of that committee and its findings. Kindly, Sandra Deviney. Okay, so what we have here, though, is we're using the system. Now, she can dismiss me or try, and if she does, I have it in writing that she thought because she took her out because she was Christian, that meant that she felt safe. Christians do not feel safe in the school.
That's right, they don't.
And so I'm gonna take her before the BC Ombudsman if she tries to dismiss me.
Good.
But the secret here and why I'm here and why I want your help is I'm from Chilliwack. So if you're from Chilliwack, I need your email. We need to stand together. We have the best chance in Chilliwack of stopping this, and if we can down one district, we can down more.
That's right.
Barry Newfield has come out against SOGI, so is Heather Moss. I was passing out sit-out flyers when I saw a group of people coming out of the gym, and I said, I'm gonna catch these people. People are better than, you know, telephone posts. So I handed them out, and who should come out as I was going in was Walter Crom. He's a trustee from Chilliwack. And so he looked at me and he said, oh, do you go to this gym? And I said, no, I don't go to this gym. Actually, I'm supposed to be using a cane right now, but it's in the car. because I have more important things to be doing. And I showed him my papers that I had in hand. And I said, Soji is hurting our children. And do you know what he said to me? I agree. I thought, okay. But then he kind of carried on and said, you know, we're trying to get the government to, you know, like he was not taking responsibility for this, that it was the government that had done this. And I said, in Chilliwack, you are our government. Yes. I said, you need to stop this.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
I think we are close to three. And I turned in this last response to her on Saturday. So she's had the long weekend and I didn't hear from her today. But what we need is, she says that she disagrees that there are parents that vehemently oppose to SOGI 123. We need to fill her inbox right now before she responds to me. So these trustees feel the pressure from all of us,
yes.
Not just me.
Yes.
So, what's my email address?
Enovac@sc35. Enovac.
Elizabeth Novak's. Yeah, Novak. School District 33.
Just go to the school district.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can you get it? And send a copy to all the trustees.
Yes, all of them.
And carbon copy Sandy. What's your email?
My email is Sandy. SEE at shaw.ca.
If you guys are okay with it, we can share all your emails and give them to Sandy and she can email you out and give you that information.
I can send you a copy of the challenge itself and the things that they need to address so you know what you're talking about on this challenge and that I'm not standing alone.